been teaching for 37 years.
34 years.
Wow. This is my 19th year.
I miss much about this building. I'll miss the floor. I love my floor. I love the people I work with. I'll miss my floor, but the building itself, I won't miss anything.
And I graduated in 1982, and I have very fond memories of the field house. I spent a lot of time after school at the field house and had a lot of fun with my teammates. And so I just loved the architecture of the field house. The rounded ceiling was really cool.
I know we're going to love the new building because it's new and everything, but it's the same way you feel when you lose a friend.
What will I miss most about this building? The people in it. The people in it.
When you walk in, you automatically feel like you're at home. There's artwork all over the walls. It's very comfortable, and I don't think we're going to get that part of Franklin High School at the new school, so I'm really going to miss that.
The building itself, I don't think I'm going to miss that much. I mean, this is Fieldhouse is a wonderful structure. I think the town is going to miss this facility. As far as the other things, I think it's the people that are inside the building that I'm going to miss the most. The students in particular, the colleagues that I've worked with over the years, the administration, the coaches, and the camaraderie with all those people.
My room.
My favorite memory is always senior sign-out day. It's a day that I get to see a lot of kids that I don't normally see, and it's just a very exciting day.
I will always remember my high school graduation and then coming to graduations as a teacher. I think the field house is a really special place.
The students and I have developed a handshake that we use all the time, and I have a lot of fun with that.
The graduation of my class that I had the honor of being class advisor for, the class of 2012, so that'll be my fondest memory.
Aerosmith played here in the field house. Did you know that?
Mm-hmm.
You didn't know that? That was kind of cool.
I don't know, probably when I went to school here, probably is probably my favorite memory.
What's changed the most over my 30-plus years, is, I'd have to say, is the integration of technology into the classrooms. And I'm probably getting out at the right time because I'm a bit of a dinosaur when it comes to technology.
Well, I was a student at Franklin High School. I graduated from here in 2006, so my favorite memory would have to be the all-night party on graduation night.
Going to see all the plays. The high school drama department here, the theater department, excuse me, is fantastic. And I particularly liked seeing A Streetcar Named Desire and One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest. Those were my absolute favorite moments.
Well, when I first started here, there used to be a lot more different choices for students. We used to have home ec, where the you would learn kitchen skills. We used to have classes for business math or just basic math concepts, so that, you know, learn how to use a checkbook, things like that, or more applications. And we also had more things like auto shop. So those things woodworking kinds of classes. Now we have a lot of computer things, but I still think some of the basic skills are being missed now because of all the times that we had to cut back in over the years.
I have a lot less freedom than I used to have. I used to be free to do all kinds of different things. Now I can't do that anymore. I used to bring in animals and all kinds of stuff. They don't let me do that anymore.
The traffic of students in my office, I think with each year, I have less kids that come into the office for a variety of reasons, and so I would say that's a good thing.
Probably the art. Getting to see over the years the art get put up on the walls and then change. Some things have been kind of painted over or modified, and then some have stayed the same.
One, two, three, my baby don't mess around because she loves me so, and this I know for sure.
Come on. then what makes something, what makes something, what makes something.